She was Madonna to fellow teachers, librarian, past council board members, church volunteers, choir members, and friends. And this woman, no matter what you call her, could do a lot of things really well. She could sing, not like that Madonna, she'd say. Play the piano, write musicals and songs, sew, cook, bake, and craft like no other. She could also drive a tractor, and she had the greatest thumb of anyone I know. She loved chocolate, Cleveland Indians, small ripe potato chips, instant decaf coffee, peanuts, and a gator without flour on TV. Even after her stroke, music stayed in her heart and mind, she could still sit down at the piano and play songs from them. Yes, she was a lot of things to a lot of people, but to all of us, she was mom, grandma, and great-grandma. And she was our world. In this role as mom, grandma, and great-grandma, she unknowingly passed on lots of wisdom over the years. I wanted to share a few of these lessons with you today. I call this list Madonna's advice. Number one, take a nap every day after work. Don't call it a nap. Say you're resting your eyes. Number two, when it comes to recipes, feel free to just use them as a guide. If the recipe calls for vanilla pudding and you're out, no worries. You can use tapioca. You need 2 cups of flour? Just eyeball. It'll be fine. Number three, speaking of cooking, when you cook and bake, make a lot. You are feeding an army, even though there might only be 6 people. But there could be 45, so prepare. When a job gets done, just take matters into your own hands. Besides your tire and your kitchen window where your husband's working, just take that and get started on replacing it. You don't need a man to help with that stuff. Number five, laugh. Laugh so hard it makes you cry. If you don't cry while you're laughing, really even laughing. Number six, don't sweat the small stuff. Messy house, it's okay. It's more important to rest your eyes. Number seven, don't throw away anything. Save newspaper articles and magazines for your kids and grandkids. Save these items until you have a big stack and put them in a grocery bag for delivery. Ignore the fact that your children will just recycle these when they get home. Number eight, when I say don't throw away anything, I mean it. Old pantyhose, keep them. Leftover felt, keep it. Egg cartons, you betcha. Milk jugs, you know what to do. After all, I need those things for a craft. Number nine, shopping 101. Go all the time, buy all the things. Buy more of the things that are on sale, even if you don't need them. Number 10, dining out. Arrive when you're personally hungry and eat light by ordering a blooming onion and french fries. Number 11, hide chocolate everywhere in the house. Keep lots of salty snacks on hand and refer to shopping 101 to buy off in case there's a shortage of chocolate or salty snacks. Number 12, cheer for your own teams. Go try, go round, go bucks. Watch them, but then get so angry you want to throw things on the TV. Speaking of sports, when things get heated, watching your own kids play sports, turn around so you can't see what's going on. Number 13, say yes to your kids, even if that involves adopting a raccoon named Rascal as a pet, or driving a 2-seater Corvette to school for your kids and their book bags in tow. 14, something on your mind? Go ahead and say it. Don't mince words. This includes suggesting that people go quiet type on the regular. Number 15, donate your time generously, volunteer to help. Better yet, just volunteer to be in charge. You want your kids to be in a Christmas play? Write it. Then play the songs on the piano, direct the musical, and make all the costumes. Sleep is overrated. Besides, you can rest your eyes tomorrow. Number 16, bake cookies all the time, but especially at Christmas. Be sure to make everyone's favorite. Especially cut out Santa's, green marshmallow holly, and chocolate-covered peanuts and cashews. Mom, we are so grateful to you for these lessons and so many more. You raised us all to have a strong Catholic faith and taught us to trust in God's plan, especially during challenging times. You believed in us and encouraged us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you. In the waters of baptism, Madonna died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life, so as to open up the entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Madonna to be inscribed in the book of life. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
This time I invite you to be seated for the proclamation of our scripture.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord
the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him. He will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right, and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him and say, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you? And the king will say to them in reply, Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me. Then he will say to those on his left, Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill in prison, and you did not care for me. Then they will answer and say, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or ill, or in prison, and not minister to your needs? He will answer them, Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me. And these will go out to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Certainly you're laying that foundation for what they're going to be saying that they all had her in first grade. They were a little afraid of her for a little bit because she didn't tolerate nonsense. She kind of laid down that law. But then as they got older and looking back, they saw what she was doing. She was laying that foundation for respect. And I could go on and on and on about how she volunteered her time at the school, how she made priest vestments, how she did things at the Seneca County Fair. But the bottom line is that she served others, but ultimately she was serving Christ. She was serving our Lord Jesus Christ. And so, yes, a funeral is sad. But I think we ought to look at the opportunity to be rejoicing as well, because we've got a woman here whose life was lived very, very well. And we know that our merciful Lord is taking her to himself. And what's also important to remember that all the ways that she served you here in this life, she's doing that still today in an even more powerful way by praying for you. She's still present to you in an even more powerful way. And how wonderful that is. So certainly on behalf of myself, and I know I talked to Father Jonathan the other day, he extends his condolences, and I also talked to Father Keith, who brought her out of retirement to be the principal. He sends his prayers as well. So on behalf of all of us, know of our very sincere prayers. And may the Lord, who is the Prince of Peace, be your comfort and your peace during this very, very difficult time. Please stand as we present our prayers and our petitions before our Lord. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Madonna, loving wife, mother, and grandmother, who adoptively was given the pleasure of her life, may she be admitted to the company of saints and find rest and peace in the arms of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the friends and family of Madonna, such a Vincent, that their pain be softened by the prayers of others and to find comfort in their faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all teachers, farmers, nurses, and doctors, let our sacrifice be remembered as an above mission of serving others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, especially our Uncle Paul and great grandparents, may have the reward of goodness in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who fall asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole church and all of us assembled here today, that we may be gathered again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now invite you, please be seated. Please stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand, for the praise of the Lord and me, for our good and the all of his holy church.
Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Madonna, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
No.
Mother, Mr. Reed, Mother, we will be your dead, Lord, and profess your
thanksgiving, this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with this Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance from your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for failing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm faith and charity, your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Madonna, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh of those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious God body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to their passing through this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. servant Madonna, who has journeyed from this world, may by his sacrifice be cleansed and free from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Madonna, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Madonna again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our sister.